galaxies. It's also said that galaxies are your complete address is a part of much larger system than your street, city, state, country, and even the planet Earth. So what does it mean? It means you are not only belonging into this Earth, because there are greater parts. Total universe is belong to us, and we are only in a part of this. You know, even at the planet, we are simply a part of this. Then, what do you mean by this? You also live in the Milky Way galaxy. So, first of all, think you are part of a galaxy, and within this galaxy, it's called a Milky Way galaxy, where we belong. And this is the picture of a Milky Way galaxy, and we are only a part of this entity, entire object. Then comes to the definitions, classifications, and formations of galaxies. Galaxies are a large groups of stars, dust, and gas. Come in a variety of shapes and sizes, and also there are large galaxies which contain more than a trillion stars. And Hubble Space Telescope has helped us understand the different types of galaxies. Then these are classified by their different shapes. Okay, then it's a galaxy. A large group of stars, dust, and gas held together by gravity. So how this gas, dust, and also stars hold together? Because due to the gravity force within themselves, which bind them together. Spiral galaxies. You can see here a picture like a spiral thing. This is called a spiral galaxies. It has a bulge at the center. At the center, it has a bulge and have a spiral arms, and also arms made up of gas, dust, and new stars. And examples, Andromeda and our Milky Way galaxy. Then our Milky Way galaxy also a spiral shape of galaxy. Then also we have some interesting facts regarding the galaxy. That is, Earth is about 2/3 of the distance from the center of the Milky Way to the edge of the Milky Way. So it's a very important fact to note. That is, Earth is about 2/3 of the distance, okay, from the center of the Milky Way. So from the center of the Milky Way, Earth is 2/3 of the distance. Okay. Then next one is, our solar system revolves around the galaxy every 200 million years. So our solar system also revolves the galaxy, and it revolves every 200 million years. So it revolves 200 million of years. Okay. Then the last time the solar system was in its current position was during the Triassic period. So what do you mean by Triassic period, and how do you identify this Triassic period? What happened there? At that period, dinosaurs first appeared on the earth. So it's the time of origination of the dinosaurs, when dinosaur appeared in the earth. Okay. Then other spiral galaxies, some other spiral galaxies, one is bird galaxies, that is much like spiral galaxies, but have two distant bars versus many spiral arms. So it has no spiral arms, rather it has two distant bars. Other bird galaxies, you can just see here some pictures, blurred pictures are here. So, and then elliptical galaxies, that is about one third of all the galaxies. So elliptical galaxies hold the one third position of all the total galaxies, and it's simply a massive blob of stars. So in the elliptical galaxies, there are massive bulb of stars and spherical or more stretched out. So the characteristics of elliptical galaxies are they are spherical and more stretched out. Then very bright centers with little extra gas and dust. So it has a very bright center and with very little extra gas and dust. So you can just visualize here, just a very bright center, and alongside this center there is little mound of gases and dust, and contain mostly old stars. So in this elliptical galaxies there are very old stars, not new stars are here. Then lenticular galaxies, there are also other types of galaxies that is called lenticular galaxies. What was the characteristics of these types of galaxies? It has both a bulge and a disk. So it has bulge and also it has a disk. So all the stars are thought to be old. So in this galaxies, it's thought that all the stars are very old here and have no spiral arms, and it has no spiral arms. You can just visualize here, it has no spiral arms, and there is little or no gas, and you can not trace any type of gas here. Then there is also an irregular type of galaxies that has don't tend to fit into any other class. It has no other class definitions, and also its shape is very irregular, and also no center bars, and may have been formed by the collisions of two or more galaxies. So how does it form? It is formed with the collisions of two or more galaxies. So you have to note here that it is formed with the collisions of two or more galaxies. So collisions of two or more galaxies happen here in the formation of the irregular galaxies. Then many are close in proximity to larger spiral galaxies. So these types of irregular galaxies are very closely existed with the larger spiral galaxies, and perhaps the spiral galaxies are distorting the shape of irregular galaxies. And as spiral galaxies are very close to these type of irregular galaxies, it happens that these spiral galaxies are distorting the shape of irregular galaxies. That's why these types of galaxies are so much irregular in shapes. It can hold its proper shape. Then you can have a question of what are the galaxies composed of? What are the ingredients of the galaxies? Or you know, there are billions of stars. Then also some planetary systems are here, and also gas clouds and star cluster. These are the ingredients of a galaxy. And there is also a nebula, one type of galaxy, named a large cloud of dust and gas in interstellar space. And a region in space, nebula is regarded here a region which in a space where stars are born or where stars explode at the end of their lives. So this is the birthplace and the destruction place of stars. It says that stars are born or stars explode at the end of their lives. So these are important thing to note here. Then spiral galaxies usually have nebula, but elliptical galaxies contain very few. So in a case of a spiral galaxy, we can trace the existence of nebula here. But in case of elliptical galaxies, there are very few of them. And there are some pictures of Irregular nebulas. You can just find here the shape of this type of nebulas are eagle-like. That's why it's called eagle-shaped nebula. And scientists believe that stars are being born in the pillars of this nebula. And there is other types of nebulas are here. That is, you can just see the pictures here of various types of nebulas. And then star clusters. What does it mean? It means globular clusters, one type of star clusters. What does it mean? A group of older stars looks like a ball, contains up to 1 million stars. So it's all one type of cluster. There are older stars, then it look like ball, contains up to 1 million stars. That is called globular clusters. Then also star cluster. This is a cluster of stars and it's shaped like stars. These are, you can just visualize the pictures here. So star clusters here is called some open clusters. A group of stars that are close together relative to surrounding stars. So there are surrounding stars very closely related to each other, and it's called open cluster. And the Pleiades are an open cluster. So this is an example. There are one type of star clusters are Pleiades. It's an open cluster. Then quasars. Quasars are also star-like, and they are very luminous. You can just visualize here a picture. It has luminous characteristics and it's a star-like, and it generates a lot of energy, and these quasars generate huge amount of energies and may be caused by massive black holes in the cores of some galaxies. So why quasars created? It's believed that in a core of the galaxy there are black holes, and black holes may cause this type of quasars. Then thought to be the most distant objects in the universe. So quasars are thought to be the most distant friends of our universe, and it's 6 billion light years away. Can't you imagine how far this type of quasars are? 6 billion light years away. My God. Then origin of galaxies. How this galaxy originated? There are some traces are here. The first question maybe, how this looking through a telescope, like looking back in time. Whenever you are looking through the telescope, that means you are looking back the time. You are just going the past to count the origins of our universe. And it's looking at distant galaxies reveals what early galaxies may have looked like. And what we have learned so far from these galaxies tutorial, that is, the universe consists of billions of galaxies, number one. Then number two, the galaxies are classified by shapes. So you have understood that the galaxies are classified by their shapes, spiral, elliptical, there are star clusters, open star clusters, various types of clusters or galaxies. Then also, the Milky Way galaxy is a spiral galaxy. Why we are just emphasizing on this Milky Way? Why? Because, you know, we are living in Earth and we have also a solar system. So this Earth is a part of our total solar system, and our total solar system is also a part of this Milky Way galaxy. That's why we are emphasizing on the Milky Way galaxy to make better understand of our existence. Then also, studying a galaxies helps scientists understand the origin on our galaxy and the universe. So the research on a different galaxy helps us to understand our own galaxy and to make us clear how it originated, how our galaxy originated, how this Earth came to being, these types of things.